That's right, Dan. Dan, and that chase shut down traffic here at North Main and Laurel Drive and kept police busy as nearly all patrol units worked to try and stop the driver speeding through these streets, narrowly avoiding injuring bystanders.
Salinas residents were caught in the crossfire as a man led police on a high-speed chase throughout town.
He just slammed into me. Tried to pit it at Cherokee.
The driver sped through several blocks of surface streets and the parking lots of shopping centers, dodging police for miles.
Pit unsuccessful.
He made his way to North Main and Laurel Drive, where traffic slowed him down.
I actually thought the car was trying to get out of the way so the police could get by to catch the suspect. I didn't realize that the car was the suspect.
That's when the man tried to wedge his way through, damaging the cars of other drivers on the road.
Then at that point, I backed up because I was just kind of afraid of what would happen to me and my family. And then when I backed up, the car unwedged and just took off, and then the officers shot at him.
A stray bullet hit another man's car just inches from his head. The chase continued to Davis Road near West Rossi Street, where the driver drove down a steep embankment and fled on foot.
Watch crossfire. We're in front of him.
Police arrested him soon after and transported him to the hospital for treatment.
And there are a few details available about the man in custody tonight, and it's unclear at this point what started the car chase to begin with. But after ramming into several police cars and other cars on the road, it's likely that this man will be facing serious charges. Dan.
All right. Thank you very much. Appreciate it. Because the man was shot by police, the district attorney will review their decision-making process of the police and investigate the incident.